The genome is the same in every cell in your body, but only certain genes are on in each cell. Okay. So obviously, it's not the sequence, but it's the structure of these genes in each cell that determines if they can be accessed and used. So the question is then, what is the structure that determines if genes can be accessed and used? That really is what makes a brain cell a brain cell, and a muscle cell a muscle cell, and also every human being different. And so what we're really trying to understand is the local structure and the global 3D organization, both in the nucleus and when it gets inherited across cell division in mitotic chromosomes. What are those structures? How do we inherit information? And if we understand those structures, can we now begin to actually manipulate it to impart new functions and actually cure intractable diseases? One of the challenges really in biology is trying to be able to see a structure in as what's called as natural a state as possible, okay? And so how do you see it without disturbing it?
Chromatin is how the genome is organized inside a cell. For a long time, people were able to basically study chromatin structure by electron microscopy. However, what people do is they have to basically take the cell and break apart the cell and look at the chromatin structure. What is the chromatin structure inside intact cell? And can we find a method or a technique that can enable us to visualize chromatin structure in a cell?
So what we did is we identified a fluorescent DNA binding dye that when you shine light on it, it has this really amazing property, which is that it catalyzes a metal polymer, a cast, across the surface of DNA and chromatin, the nucleus, that enables it to be visualized in the electron microscope. Life occurs in 3D, right? Its form gives way to function. And so the new technique really allows you to reconstruct the three-dimensional structure, those shapes, those surfaces that catalyze, that determine, physically, if genes can be accessed or used. And you can visualize it as a continuum and take a trip sort of from the top to the bottom of the nucleus. And you see its structure as basically an enzyme would see it, as a transcription factor would see it, as a virus would see it. So really being able to see now the fine structure and global 3D organization of DNA could really enable us to design drugs that change its structure and organization to make a tumor cell remember how to be normal again, and to impart new functions that improve and change the human condition, right? Because when you see something, you begin to understand in an entirely new way. It's really exciting, actually.